Thank you, Mr. President. I seek leave to make a brief explanation before addressing a question without notice to the Minister for Regional Development on the topic of renting in the regions and cost of living concessions. This morning, Premier Malinauskas and Minister Cook held a press conference announcing the state government's commitment to bring forward the cost of living concession payments to August this year. Previously, some recipients were due to receive their payment in March 2023. In August, homeowner occupiers who are eligible to receive the cost of living concession will receive $449 to assist with their cost of living expenses, while eligible renters will receive just half of that, $224.60. We know that more South Australians than ever before are experiencing rental stress. This is particularly acute in regional areas where prices have surged by almost 70% over the last 2 years. My question to the minister is the minister concerned that renters in regional areas are being shortchanged by the cost of living concession, and will she be advocating for renters to receive the same payment as homeowners as part of the government's review of these concessions?
Thank you, Mr. President, and I thank the honourable member for his question. And certainly I was also delighted to be able to hear the announcement today that effectively the cost of living concession will be doubled as we go forward in this period of time. Certainly I think there's an important need to be constantly looking at the concessions that we have in our state. They're a very important part of supporting those who need that assistance at various times throughout their life. And I will be happy to refer the substance of his question to the Minister of Human Services in the other place.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Mr. Sims.
Will the minister be advocating for renters in the regions to get the same concession as homeowners, given the crisis gripping regional South Australia?
Minister.
I'm constantly in discussions with the Minister for Human Services, as indeed most members, I'm sure, on this side of the chamber, about how we can best address the cost of living concerns and issues being faced by people across our state.
The Minister's view on those challenges, how does she consider we can best address this?
Not sure that it comes from the original answer, and you're looking for an opinion, I believe. The Honourable Mr. Wade.